Hello, Dissenters. My name is Etalyx, and today I want to look briefly into Total War Warhammer. It just released on Steam yesterday, and it's the newest iteration of the Total War franchise. It stands apart from previous entries in the series with its uniquely fantasy setting. Warhammer itself, of course, originated with Games Workshop sometime back in, I want to say, the 1980s. And Total War seems like a natural fit for it, with capacity for thousands of units on screen at the same time, and sweeping strategic decisions to make on the battlefields and the overarching grand campaigns. First though, a disclaimer. I've only had cursory experience with previous Total War games, and next to no experience or knowledge of the Warhammer universe. So I'm coming into this as a blank slate. I put about 5 hours into the game so far, and I want to tell you how I feel about it as a noob, as well as describe a few of the intricacies and the details of how the game is played. 95% of my time so far has been dedicated to playing as the dwarves in the dwarf campaign, so they are the natural enemies of the orcs, aka the greenskins. But you don't have to play as dwarves at all. There's four full campaigns initially: the Empire, aka the humans, the dwarves, the vampire counts, and the orcs, also known as the greenskins, as I just said. A fifth, called the Chaos Warriors, are available as DLC, but that DLC is temporarily free provided you own the game within a week of its launch. And a lot of people are pretty mad about that, it seems, from my perusal of the internet. Anyway, the campaigns themselves are a bit difficult to describe. They aren't story campaigns like you'd expect to find in other single-player RTS like StarCraft, though there is a story that kinda goes with them. The campaign is split into two. Half of the game will be fought on the battlefields with scores of troops facing off with you at the tactical helm. And the other half is a campaign map where politics, like alliances and trades, need to be enacted, and armies positioned for optimal engagements. Territorial defenses and attacks, all that stuff. Each of the races will play very differently from one another. Each faction has unique abilities and restrictions. For example, dwarfs hold grudges. So if some greenskins raid one of your settlements, the offense will be written down into the Book of Grudges that the dwarfs keep record with. If you don't avenge that grudge, you can't win the campaign. In this way, the story always begins the same, but based on your actions and strategic decisions on the grand map, progresses uniquely in such a way that you're basically making up your own story to a certain degree as you go along. Dwarfs also have no cavalry or magical abilities, and magic is a pretty big divergence, as I've come to understand, from the Total War norm. Huge spells that whirlwind enemy formations into the sky or summon undead beings from the ground beneath your enemy's feet. I imagine that the Empire and the vampires would excel at this kind of magic, so you may be more interested in playing their campaigns instead. Additionally, there's specific strengths and weaknesses that you have to prepare for and play around. Dwarfs and orcs, for example, can take shortcuts through mountains and other terrain obstacles on the grand campaign map, but sometimes they end up running into each other for epic tunnel fights where no side can retreat, and whoever loses, loses everything. There's a decent tutorial in place that'll guide you through the opening maneuvers, but as with all strategy games, you're gonna have to use the internet to fill in the gaps to some extent. The tutorial instills a bit of false sense of confidence, like, yeah, that's pretty easy, won that fight no problem. And then BAM! You accidentally kill off your entire army in a fight you couldn't win because you couldn't understand why your archers wouldn't fire because they were too close to friendly troops and couldn't shoot over their shoulders and risk team killing them, so they just sat there and didn't shoot at all, and oh no, how did enemy reinforcements arrive from behind me? I must not have seen them come in. There's a pause button? Wait, why is it hotkey to pee? That's not an accessible button at all, and I don't remember you telling me I could pause, and I didn't figure it out until I played the game for 4 full hours. And the AI puts me a pretty good challenge. I played on hard mode and was constantly getting flanked by enemy cavalry and bombarded by archers who always managed to stay just far enough away from my infantry, baiting them away from my main group before getting them swallowed up by other units lying in wait. The campaign itself is really satisfying as well, with plenty of technology to unlock and a huge tech tree, as well as individual upgrades for your lords as they level up to help out your nearby troops to inspire them to continue fighting. Settlements can be built up with new buildings and upgrades, and random events give you a choice as to what type of leader you will be for your faction. Decide how to move your troops around the map, march them to make them go further per turn. It is turn-based, but it'll make them more tired in combat, and you need to end your turn when they've gone far enough and you have nothing else to do. If the campaign itself isn't really enough, there's also about 37 unique quest battles accessible from the main menu, and each of these appears to have a little brief setup with dialogue and predefined armies.
Surround the crone, slay the creature before she can summon her minions.
Which gives you access to huge battles instantly at the click of a button after you wait for it to load, which can be a while. Sometimes the objectives are a little bit crazy, like the one I tried wanted me to hold out for an entire hour against waves of troops. A little bit more commitment than I'm willing to give there, Mr. Quest Battle. There's also quick battles, though, if you're in a hurry, where you can set up the forces however you like against the AI or play versus online with others. But I'm too much of a pansy to take the fight online, so have not tried that yet. My only real complaint so far with Total War Warhammer are the loading times and how initially complex the game is. Each time you want to load into a campaign for the first time after booting up Total War Warhammer, prepare to wait for a while before everything gets into position. I'm sure lower-end PCs will struggle with all the stuff happening on screen, but I'm able to maintain a consistent 60 frames per second on Ultra on the smaller battles and consistent 60 FPS on high settings for the larger battles that I've been taking part in. And that's with a GTX 980 Ti and an i7 4790K. As far as difficulty, that is a complaint that I think is eased with more time in the game. There's just so many tactical decisions that need to be made. Flank their archers with your cavalry and mow them down here. Hold the line here and maintain formation, or charge to this position, but you tire out your troops. Keep your lord here for maximum army buffs with the little circle around them that inspires them. And if we hold here, ranged enemies will just take us out for free. The list goes on. Tactically, it seems exceptionally deep, but I've seen some veterans of the Total War franchise complain that it's been dumbed down from previous iterations, which, of course, is a complaint that sails clear over my head, having no experience. If you got a decent computer and an itch for something strategic, then I think Warhammer's really compelling. I feel like I'm just hitting the tip of the iceberg in the Dwarf campaign with 4 or 5 hours in, and potentially there's 4 more factions to campaign whole different campaigns in the future. There's a lot of content here. I have been in a real strategy mood recently, playing a lot of Stellaris and Total War Warhammer now. I just want to have those giant maps that I slowly conquer as my army grows and moves across the lands, taking all their enemies and grudges out with a vengeance. There's so much I'm unable to cover here in this video. I wanted to give you just a brief overview. There's rock, paper, scissors galore with the combat and the units. Worrying about whether your vanguard of little axe-wielding dwarves is going to hold the line against the encroaching cavalry who's just going to march right through them, protecting your catapults in the back from flankers and making sure that your archers are far enough away with visibility to shoot what they need to shoot. Positioning is key, and there's a lot of help in the game to make that easy for you. You can zoom all the way out for a tactical overhead battlefield bird's eye view, or you can hold space and see where all the units are going, and that'll help you set up their formations when you want them to move. So I like that all that information is represented very easily and handily on screen, and I also love the ability to pause. At the higher difficulty levels, I think that pausability might disappear, but for people like myself who are brand new to the game, I need as much time as I can get. And if you want a little in between, you can also play in slow-mo mode and still have control over your troops, and still get to watch it progress without having to worry about pausing or unpausing. Overall, really enjoying Total War Warhammer, and I encourage you to check it out if you are even a little bit interested. It can be very daunting at first, I agree, but the reward is worth it, I think. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you appreciated it, and I hope that we'll get to see some more Total War Warhammer in the future, maybe on a stream or something. Let me know what you think down in the comments below. Thank you for watching once again. My name is Etalyx, and I'll see you next time.